G'day everyone, I'm Nathan Hode, and I'm making a classic adventure game about our cat, Coco. In this video, I'm going to talk about how I handle transitioning between locations. There's three parts to this whole thing. The location manager that handles connections between locations, a special node that handles the player needing to transition between locations, and then the transitions themselves. I'll start with the location manager. The role of the location manager is to keep track of all of the places in the game and how they are connected, so which door goes to which interior or which cave entrance goes into which cave and so on. This is actually the third iteration of my location handling system. The first one was just a dictionary that I manually wrote out that contained a list of scenes and the locations within them. Then I rewrote it to be a proper plugin and tried to simplify it by removing the concept of scenes and just having a list of all locations in the whole game. Once I had that working, it was immediately apparent how unruly that list was going to get. So, third time's a charm. I rewrote it again to bring it closer to that original setup, but with some better UI to manage things. When I'm in a scene and have a location trigger node selected, more about them later on, I can tell it which location this is from the list of locations that are known to be in this scene. If I need to add a new one, I can also just add one here. To manage the connections and see the full list of scenes and locations, I can click Manage Locations. From here, I can update the names and connections between things. At this stage, there are only scenes and locations as entity types, but I can see that eventually I'll need a way to group scenes into regions or something to better keep track of scenes that are related. You might be thinking, why didn't I build this as a big graph to show the connections between locations in a more spatial way? I'm no stranger to making graph-based stuff, and that did cross my mind, but I didn't feel like the effort involved in handling everything that comes with managing a graph was going to move the needle for what I was trying to accomplish for now. I have a few ideas for how I'd show the spatial relationships between connections, but that's for future me to worry about. Now let's have a look at this location trigger node. It extends Area 2D and is for detecting when the player approaches a door or some other trigger for a location change. My location manager includes an inspector plugin that provides this dropdown to choose the location associated with this location trigger. The location manager takes care of the mapping between this location and its destination. When the player enters the area, it emits a destination requested signal and provides the scene path and the location ID of where to go next. In my game, I've made another custom node that extends this one to then handle some game-specific stuff like the player's initial facing direction, opening and closing doors, and scene transitions. In this extra node, I automatically connect the destination requested signal and then pass it to my transition handler. The transitions aren't really the responsibility of the location manager, so I handle them separately. Let's have a look at them now. Transitions is an auto-loaded scene. It's mostly straightforward with just a color rect and an animation player. There's a shader on the color rect that gets animated by the animation player. So it goes from covering none of the screen through to covering all of the screen and back again. At the halfway point, when the entire screen is covered, I swap out the current scene to the new one. You can do lots of interesting transition stuff with shaders, but for this video, I'll just talk about this simple circle transition. We give it a radial gradient and a progress value. The progress value is used as a kind of filter for the gradient. The gradient goes from black to white or 0 to 1, so the progress is a value between 0 and 1. So for any given pixel, we check the current progress value against the color of the pixel in the gradient. If its value is above the progress, then it's transparent, otherwise it's black. As the progress value changes over time, the amount of the gradient showing as black will change, so you get the idea. So putting all of these things together means I can easily map one location to another. I do plan on releasing the location manager as an open source plugin in the future, but for now I want to dog food it a bit first to see how it feels. If you can't wait to check it out, then I've thrown up the code for the base location manager as it is now on my Patreon. Beware though, there be dragons. There's not really much documentation beyond this video, and it doesn't include the transition stuff. And speaking of my Patreon, you can find all of the other code snippets that I've shared in my previous videos there too. I'd also like to thank this month's Cockatoo patron, Vanillid. Okay, as always, if you have a question or comment, then throw it below or jump into my Discord. I'm curious to hear how everybody else handles location connections in their game. And if you aren't already subscribed to this channel, then you should definitely do that too. And that's all from me for now. Bye.